So you'll remember that in this section, this part of the course, we're looking at Markov processes in continuous time and in discrete space. So far in this part, we've seen some important examples, most notably the Poisson process, but we've also seen some birth processes and we've seen the time inhomogeneous Poisson process. But now we're going to move off from those particular examples, and now we're going to start looking at the general theory of Markov processes in continuous time and discrete space. So the idea is here that we'll be at some state and we'll wait there for some proportion of time, for some amount of time, and then we'll jump to another state. And then we'll stay at that new state for some amount of time, and then we'll jump to another state. So these are called Markov jump processes because they're continuous time, discrete space. So if we're going to study a Markov jump process, there are two things we need to know. The first question is, when we jump, where do we jump to? Obviously, we'll be picking some new state at random to jump to. And the second thing is, how long do we wait until we make that jump? That is, what is the holding time or the waiting time? So the first question, where do we jump to? We're going to study this by looking at something called a jump chain, which is actually a discrete time Markov chain that just keeps track of where we move without worrying about the times. Then the second thing, where we do have to worry about the times. Now, because we want a Markov process, something that has the Markov memoryless property, these waiting times are going to have a distribution that's memoryless. And you should remember from a few sections ago that it's the exponential distribution that has this memoryless property. So the holding times, the waiting times between the jumps, are going to have an exponential distribution. So now we're going to discuss all that, the ideas of the rate of jumping between different states, in order to write down a definition of a Markov jump process. Okay, so let's think about how we're going to do this. The key idea here is going to be the idea of a transition rate. So the transition rate from some state I to some state J will be written QIJ, and that will be some non-negative number. And that's, I guess, for I not equal to j, because we're not thinking about transitions from a state to itself. That's just like staying there for a bit longer. So the idea is this. Suppose we are at state I. Then we've got various transition rates from I. We've got QI1, QI2, QI3, QI4, and so on. So after a time, that's exponentially distributed with rate QIJ, because that's the transition rate. If we haven't yet moved, then move to J. So think about this. If you're sitting at I, you've got all these transition rates. You've got QI1 to state 1, and you've got QI2 to state 2, and QI3 to state 3, and so on. And so each of those has got its own little alarm clock, right? The edge to state 1 has got an alarm clock going off at an exponential QI1 amount of time. The move to state 2 has an alarm clock going off at exponential QI2 amount of time. The move to step J has an exponential alarm clock going off at rate QIJ. And whichever one of those alarm clocks goes off first, that's the state we'll go to, and that's the time at which we'll go to it. So, which is the when does the first alarm clock go off? That is, what is the time until we make a move? So the first alarm clock goes off. Well, that's the minimum of a bunch of exponentials. And if you remember back in section 14, I think, we proved a theorem about the minimum of exponentials. And it's exponential with the rate being the sum of the rates. So the time until we move is exponential with rate sum of the qijs, and we'll call that qi, right? So that's a definition. Qi is equal to that sum of the qijs, because that's the time until the first alarm clock goes off and we make a move. Ah, well, what's the probability that any one particular one of these alarm clocks is the one that goes off first? Well, we also saw that in Theorem 14. That was, in fact, the same theorem. And so the probability that, say, alarm clock J is the one that goes off, and therefore we move to J. And hopefully you remember this from Section 14. It was the rate to J divided by the sum of the rates. So let's call this Rij. This is a definition. And it's Qij over the sum of all those rates. And we've already called the sum of those rates Qi. So that's Qij over Qi. If I is like an absorbing state where you don't ever leave, I guess we can say that Rii is 1 and we stay there forever. And Rij is 0 for anything else. So, if you haven't been following so far, pay attention for this sentence, because this is the crucial idea, right? The crucial idea. From state I, we wait an amount of time, and that amount of time is exponentially distributed with rate qi, where qi is defined there with the red underlined bits. And then we jump to state j with probability rij, where rij is defined there in the blue underlined bits. Okay, so that has answered the two questions we had at the beginning of this subsection, which is how long do we wait and where do we move? The answer is the amount of time we wait is exponential qi, and where we move is given by these probabilities rij. So when we defined a discrete time Markov chain, we found it was useful to give this matrix, the transition matrix P. And we'd like to do something similar to define a Markov jump process. And this is normally called a generator matrix. And it's normally given the letter Q, because that's the one after P in the alphabet. So the off-diagonal elements of Q are very easy. They're Qij for J not equal to I. The off-diagonal elements where Qij is the thing we've been talking to all the way up here, this transition rate from I to J. But it turns out that on the diagonal, the convenient thing to do is something a little bit weird, which is on the diagonal, it's convenient to put Qii, the diagonal, to be minus Qi, and remember that Qi was defined as the sum of this. It just turns out that the maths will work out really nice if we put the diagonal element to be minus that Qi. So note that this means rows add to zero, right? Because the diagonal element is negative the sum of all the positive things off the diagonal. So whereas in discrete time, rows of the transition matrix added to 1, in continuous time, rows of the generator matrix add to 0. So sometimes when you're dealing with a continuous time chain, you care about how much time you spend in each state. But sometimes it's not actually important how much time you spend in each state, it just matters where you go. So if you only care about where you go, we can look at something we call the jump chain, or the jump Markov chain, and we'll call that Yn. So the jump chain Yn, or the Markov jump process, Xt. So note that you've got this Markov jump process to start with, which is continuous time. And this thing that I'm about to define for you, the jump chain, is discrete time, which is why we've put T in brackets for the continuous one and N downstairs for the discrete one. And the jump chain just keeps track of where we go. So the jump chain will start at the same place as the jump process, y0 equals x0. And yn will be the state of xt just after nth jump. In other words, the discrete time jump chain is just tracking where we move. The jump chain doesn't know how long we spend in each state, but the jump chain does know where we move. And so if we just want to keep track of where we move, we can just use the jump chain, yn, instead of the whole Markov jump process, xt. And remember, of course, as we've said, the holding time at some xt or some yn is exponential q yn. Okay, so let us go back to what we said up here for what is the big important idea. And the big important idea is this one. From state I, we wait an amount of time exponential with rate qi, and then we jump to state j with probability rij. I did feel that I wanted to write this down in a formal definition. It turns out when you actually try and write down this thing in the yellow square as a very formal mathematical definition, it gets quite long. Here is that definition, and look how long it is. So I don't propose to read all this through because it's basically just saying what was in that yellow box. But note here, we have a state space S. We have this transition matrix Q, where the off-diagonal elements are positive or at least non-negative, and the on-diagonal elements make sure the rows add up to 1. And then we have this jump chain here with transition properties Rij, which we talked about before, being Rij equals Qij over Qi. And the jump chain keeps track of where we move, and the holding times are exponential. So if you want to read all that definition, you can, but that definition is just setting out in formal mathematics what we said up here, which is that we wait in state I for an amount of time exponential Qi, where Qi is the sum of all the transition rates, and then we jump to another state J with probability Rij, where Rij is Qij over Qi. And so that tells us how long we stay in a state and where we move.